Iowa State troopers are out in force tonight.
They are hoping to make your trip to Grandma's house a bit safer this holiday season.
AAA says more than 42 million people will travel 50 miles or more for Thanksgiving. That's up from just over 40 million last year. And with more drivers comes more danger. News Channel 8's Patrick Bell has the very latest on this new safety blitz.
Well, Stacey, that brand new state law enforcement initiative is officially underway tonight. From now until Friday, you're going to see more troopers on Iowa highways and interstates for one reason and one reason only, keeping you and your family safe during the busy Thanksgiving travel season.
The blitz has begun.
I wouldn't be looking for people that aren't obeying the law.
Additional state troopers now searching for reckless motorists in hopes of preventing holiday tragedy.
Speeding. Seatbelt violations, we're going to look at following too close. We're definitely going to look for the distracted driver.
Because more traffic means more danger.
Last year we lost 8 people on the interstates and highways in Iowa. So hopefully this year we'll see a reduction in that with extra officers out there enforcing the laws. And hopefully we'll get that down to 0.
And while some accidents might not be avoidable, like this deadly collision near Madrid the day before Thanksgiving 2010, other crashes, troopers say, are.
I've seen people reading newspapers, reading books, but focus, the main thing is on your driving. Accidents are preventable. And by people realizing that, then hopefully we won't lose anybody on the interstates and highways this holiday season.
In all, 13 people died on Iowa highways and interstates during Thanksgiving week last year. And that's why troopers say it's so important to plan extra time for heavy traffic, don't speed, and don't be distracted behind the wheel. Along Interstate 235 in Des Moines, I'm Patrick Bell, KCCI News Channel 8, Iowa's news leader.
Thank you, Patrick. And during Thanksgiving week last year, 8,000 drivers were ticketed for speeding, and more than 1,000 were ticketed for seatbelt violations.